Hello and welcome to Proactive Investors. Here with me from Catalyst Metals today is Managing Director James Champion de Crespigny. James, welcome to the program.
Thank you, Alicia.
James, let's talk a little bit about your strategic acquisition of TSXV Lister Superior Gold. My understanding here is it's a joining of forces, really, between your Mary Meyer gold project over in WA, and next door is Superior's Plutonic Gold operation. You're out to create a high-grade, low-cost mining operation. Tell us more.
Thank you, Alicia. That's right. It's a significant step for Catalyst. After our acquisition earlier this year of Vango Mining, we were then able to come to an agreement with the Superior Gold, a TSX-listed company that owns the neighbouring Plutonic Gold Mine. It's a well-known gold mine in Australia with a lot of history. And by bringing the two assets together, the high-grade exploration ground that Vango owned and the Plutonic Gold Mine owned by Superior, we now have a united, consolidated gold belt of considerable significance in the Australian sector. And so that's really the aim, consolidating one belt under one roof to materially increase gold production at far lower costs.
This move means there's plenty of eyes on your West Coast work at the moment, but of course not to be forgotten is what you're doing over in Central Victoria, where you're targeting a potential extension to the historical 22 million ounce Bendigo Goldfield. What's the news here?
Yes, yesterday we announced some terribly interesting results, some 6.5 metres at nearly 200 grams. This is in an area that we've been focused on for a long time, we've known about for a long time, and long suspected it was there. It takes time in Bendigo, given the cover we're operating under there, for these secrets to let themselves be known. But our geological team, really led by my fellow director, Bruce Kay, that's had a terribly successful career. Really, that is the target, and the goal is to delineate similar, very high-grade zones under those northern extensions of the Bendigo goldfields. It does sit contiguous to the Fosterville gold mine that's had a wonderful track record with their discovery of the Swan Zone a few years back. And that is in part why we work on this project with our joint venture partners, Hancock Prospecting, to really uncover those secrets that lie below.
Certainly, as you say, that high level of cover can really be somewhat of a thing to push through here in Central Victoria. But once you do, it is certainly encouraging and exciting to see. James, all of this to say, where do you see Catalyst and its shareholders going in the coming months?
We're very focused on padding down what we've put together in Western Australia. That's our focus. There's quite a lot of work to happen there to be able to clearly articulate to people the real potential of this Plutonic Gold Belt, which we think is really a forgotten gold belt of Australia. It's never been owned by an Australian company in the past. Bits and pieces of it have been, but never as one consolidated belt. And so this consolidation, we think, is has been a long time coming. And we think there are other opportunities around the area that could add to its significance. So really, that's our focus. Bed down this consolidation, this operation, and articulate what the potential of it is, as well as other nearby consolidation opportunities as well.
Catalyst Metals Managing Director James Champion de Crespigny, thanks for bringing us up to speed on this underloved gold belt and also your work in Central Victoria. We look forward to further updates from you soon.
Thank you, Alicia.